You gotta go to the second line on Sunday.
It's crazy. Like, I still can visualize the last second line I played.
That's why our brain stopped at the last second line.
We all were in the freshman class of 2005 together, so we crab brothers. We kind of like, we in this together like blood, like family. You know, I was in the Free Agents, he was in the Stooges. I got to the Stooges, he got the TBC. A lot of people was liking the vibes that we were coming with every time we linked up together.
We brought a whole new vibe to the city, a high energy vibe.
Real
high energy. We connected to the people more than all the prior bands we were in, and just the maturity level. And then the city, we started in 2017, we released our first mixtape 6 months later. About another 6 to 8 months, we dropped another mixtape for the streets. Right. Then in 2019, we released our first album, man.
Seeing some of my peers, that's what made me really want to, you know, get down with it for the most part.
For sure. Yeah, we have a lot of peers that we deal with. Like, you'll see, like, Trombone Shorty always hollering, Corey Henry. A lot of those guys, they all kind of showed us some love in some form or fashion.
Right.
Whether we walking through the Treme playing music or the 7 Ward.
Your first few years as a musician, quarters.
Yeah, you got to go to the quarters.
You got to go to the quarters. You got to hit the corner. You kind of learn more of this music. Once you hit that area, once you there, you get the change in your style of playing, how you listening to the music.
That's what you really learn. It's like them old timers ain't gonna let you.
Yeah, they not gonna let you keep doing that.
They gonna
break a lot of bad habits, and you get to learn a lot of new things and great things that can kind of like stick with you forever.
Yeah.
So even like with that, the stuff that we have within them Big Six sound, it come from all of that. Coming across people like Wolf, Missing Link. David Andrews, you get what I'm saying? Like, you know, they got some greats that still sit in that area, and once they do see the youngsters come through, and if you're serious, you'll take it in. You're gonna be able to hold on to those lessons forever from those guys, and it's a real blessing.
Like I said, it's a lot of influences. I look up to like Leroy Jones. You can't forget the man Kermit Ruffins.
Right.
The Rebirth Brass Band.
Rebirth. Yeah, they've been showing love since day one. Like I guess we've proven ourselves to our, you know, the community and our peers, you know, to see that we're poised to, you know, do some great things. And then in a short amount of time,
Yeah.
4 years, I've seen, you know, the job have to take maybe about
10 years.
10 years before they get a scratch on the surface. And to see, you know, that we got to hit the second line scene, play almost every second line within the first year as a band. Like, that was epic. Before we even became a band, we just got together and jammed out every time. So when we did make this full circle and started creating material for this group, it just became like, you can tell the energy within the music. Yeah. Like, it clicks well. So now when you add the people to it, it goes bananas.
Yeah.
Like, especially, we love seeing that energy. It just makes us want to turn up even more.
Yeah. It's what you call it, the holy trinity, the trifecta. You get the second liners dancing in front of you, you get the band energy, then you get the sideliners, they partying, and all the energy is just one big ball of energy that's amazing.
They make you feel great, you know, like you're doing something great for them. So
and
it's
then,
like,
then in New Orleans, like music, like in the marching bands, is actually popular. Like other places, it's not popular. And that translates from middle school to high school. And like I said, even from marching band to brass band, it's like a stepping stone.
Mm-hmm.
It's that same love and that same energy. Like you said, that's something that was like religion to us. You gotta go to the second line on Sunday.
It's crazy. Like I still can visualize the last second line I played.
That's why our brain stopped at the last second line.
It's stuck right now. It's stuck. You know, I know when we get out, we're gonna do our thing though.
4 hours we might play all day.
All day. We might put on through the whole stops and everything. You never know.
So stretch and warm up, do something. You get your morning stretch, get you a coffee. Cause when you get out there, we gonna tear it down.
What?
Let the streets on fire.
Can't wait. Yeah, it's gonna be hard not seeing some of the faces. Cause you know, we lost a lot of people, but we gonna be able to remember those people because a lot of those memories still hit them sidewalks.
Yeah.
Every time we pass, those people that we ain't see out there that made it past this pandemic, there's gonna be a lot of people that we gonna be able to remember that there's some fire stuff out there in them streets, for yeah. real.
Sometimes that New Orleans vibe keeps you there. Mm-hmm. Just knowing they got that young talent coming.
And the young talent is ready.
Oh, you young talent think. Ready.
They always ready.
And there will always ready. Be young talent.
There will always be young talent. And that's the good thing about knowing that we in a good place like this will never die. Like, that's the fire part. Like, I still feel good about knowing that this won't have a fall off, like, as far as brass bands, because we got little kids right now that follow us every day with instruments, trying to learn how to play this music right now at less than 10 years old. We still have generational wealth going on with the music, with the kids.
Yeah, you never know. Like, you never know who's the next Christian Scott or Trombone Shorty or...
But
the next big thing.
You'd be surprised at some of the things that young kids will be able to do on their own, and not even know literally what they're doing. And you'd be like, man, how you did that? I don't know, just playing. Like, these little kids really could do some great things. Like, they really on some ghost stuff at
young ages.